one thing that a woman really wants to know about a man, or perhaps you might say one thing that femininity wants to know about masculinity, is that it's not a predatory tyrant. Okay, so, and here's why. I mean, first of all, there's fragility in feminine sexuality to a greater degree than there is in male sexuality, because women bear a higher price for sexual misadventure, let's say, and are perhaps more prone to exploitation by force. But more than that, part of being a woman is having the possibility of bringing something extraordinarily fragile and vulnerable and valuable into the world. And the first concern might be, are you a predator? Fundamentally, are you a predator? And so what I see happening in the feminist disciplines like gender studies is the politicization of that accusation. And the accusation is, prove to me that you're not a predator. Like in the fundamental element of your masculinity, not only historically, but now, because the cost of you being a predator is too high. Now, I feel that that's an inappropriate, I think that's what's driving the demolition of the idea of presumption of innocence, for example. We'll start with presumption of guilt and prove to me that you're innocent. And I think the problem with that isn't that there are no predatory men, because there are plenty of predatory men. The problem is that the courageous way to deal with the problem of the predator is to offer a hand in courageous trust and to invite forward a partner from the monster. That's the mythological manner in which this is supposed to be undertaken. The courageous, a courageous part of the woman's journey, let's say, is to face the monstrosity of a man and to invite out of that something more noble to emerge. And there's courage in that and genuine risk. And I think that that's foregone in the accusation process. And then the other element of that seems to me to be that, well, if you are a predator and you're irredeemable in your predatory nature, then the best thing to do is to render you harmless. And if we're going to obscure the relationship between competence and power and assume that all of your striving upward is merely a manifestation of power, then what we'll do is weaken you as much as possible so that harmlessness can replace virtue. And I see all of that driving these resentful disciplines in their ideology.
So the aim is the emasculation of the man.
Yeah, that's the evil queen.
Yeah.
Yeah, because we have the evil king, right? That's the tyrannical patriarchy. Well, the evil queen is lurking somewhere.
Yes.
So